everybody, and welcome to this week's story time. Now, last week you might remember we told you all about King Solomon and how he knew he needed God's help if he was going to be a good and wise king. But the king in today's story was not a good king. His name was Ahab. And Ahab didn't love God. And he did lots of bad and lots of really mean things. Well, the other person in today's story is a man called Elijah. And Elijah was a prophet. And a prophet was someone who listened to what God had to say and then told God's people God's messages. Well, one day God told Elijah to go to the bad King Ahab with a message. When Elijah went to see the king, he said to Ahab, "King Ahab, God is very cross with you because you have done lots of very bad and lots of very mean things instead of loving God and doing good things. So God is going to stop the rain." Oh no! When the rain stops, look what happens to plants. Oh no, this plant looks really sad, doesn't it? It's died because it hasn't had any water. And if all the plants die, then there'll be no food. And if there's no food, everyone is going to be very, very hungry. Well, when Elijah told King Ahab that God was going to stop the rain, King Ahab became so cross and angry. He was hopping mad. So angry that Elijah had to run away. Now, it's very hard to run away from a powerful king. And so Elijah had to run so far away, he ended up in the desert. Now, in the desert, it's very hot, and everywhere you look, there is sand. Sand over there, sand over there, nothing but sand. What was Elijah going to do when he got thirsty? Well, fortunately, God was looking after Elijah, and so he led him to a lovely stream that was flowing in the desert. There aren't very many streams in the desert, but God found one for Elijah. So every day Elijah could go to the stream and have lots to drink. Fantastic. But what was Elijah going to do when he got hungry? Well, God was looking after Elijah, and so every day he sent birds. I've got an owl here. I think they were actually ravens. But every day birds would come with bread and give the bread to Elijah. So every day he had plenty to eat. Now, you may be wondering why Elijah loved and cared for God. It was because God loved and cared for Elijah. Well, we're going to sing a song together. And it's this: "My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do." Elijah knew that. Sing along if you know the words, and we'll see you again next time. Bye-bye.
God so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. And the mountains are His, the valleys are His, the stars are His handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are His, the valleys are His, the stars are His handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are His, the valleys are His, the stars are His handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
There's nothing my God cannot do.